Hello students, welcome back to the class. During the last class we have discussed about the rule of law. Okay, in this class we are going for a very new topic which is called as defined liberty and various types of liberty. So in this class we will discuss about liberty, introduction, meaning, definition, and then we will discuss about what are the various types of liberties are there. Okay, we will go forward. First one, introduction point. This is the first point we have to remember. Okay, introduction is the first thing, second thing meaning, and third one definition. So whenever if you are writing the answers, first introductions, meaning, definition, in a systematic way you have to write it. I'll go forward. Introduction, liberty. Liberty is quite distinctive qualities of man when you are comparing with animals. So liberty is quite a distinctive quality, which is quite different quality. Okay, man, so the liberty quality is quite distinctive qualities when you are comparing man with when you are comparing with animals. Okay, man have more liberty. Okay, next come to the point, when you wanted to understand the sense of liberty, okay, you have to understand two important sense. One is called positive sense, negative sense. Liberty, okay, this is first we have to understand the sense of liberty. Liberty is mainly consists of two important sense. One is positive sense as well as negative sense. Now come to the point, in liberty is nothing but in negative sense, in liberty, if there is an absence of restraints or constraints, then that type of liberty is called as negative liberty. Okay, so to understand the liberty we have to understand two sense. One is called positive sense and one is called negative sense. I explain you what is meant by negative sense now. What is called negative sense? From the liberty when we are removing, okay, if there is an absence of, restraints or constraint, then that is called as negative liberty. What then? You will get one doubt, sir, what is meant by restraints? Restraints are nothing but act of stopping or holding back. Whenever there is an act of stopping something to do, there is an act of stopping or holding back, that is called restraining, restricting. Restricting is nothing but you are restraining someone to do something. You are not allowing to perform something. So act of stopping or holding back, that is called as restraints. Okay, restraints. And constraints means something that limits or restricts someone, same thing. When you are restricting someone to do something, that is called, or you are making someone to be in the limit, okay, or you are restricting someone to do some activities or performance, so that is called as constraint. So first what we have understand, liberty. So liberty is quite a very different quality in the man when we are comparing with the animals. So when you are understanding about the liberty, we have to understand two important sense. One is called negative sense, positive sense. Negative sense in the liberty, in the sense, whenever in the liberty, if there is an absence of restraints or if there is an absence of constraints, then that is called as negative liberty. You will get a doubt, what is meant by restraint? Restraints are nothing but the act of stopping someone or holding back. That is called restraint or act making a limit. If you are asking someone to be in the limit, okay, that is called as constraints. Now this is about negative liberty. If there is an absence of restraints or constraints in liberty, if there is an absence of restraints and constraints, that is negative liberty. Now positive liberty means removing all the possible constraints, same thing. Whenever if you are removing any restrictions, okay, all the possible restrictions when you are removing for the development of human beings, then that is called as positive liberty. Okay, so whenever if you are removing all type of restrictions, okay, all type of holding back when you are, okay, all type of restrictions, constraints when you are removing from the liberty, why you are removing that liberty for the development of human beings, when you are removing all type of restriction, then that is called as positive liberty. So we have understand two important sense of liberty. One is called negative liberty and positive liberty. What we have understand in the negative liberty? In the negative liberty, if there is an absence of restraints or constraints, that is called negative liberty. Restraints are nothing but, here it was written, the act of stopping or holding back. Constraints are nothing but something that is limit or restricting someone to do. So that is called as constraint. So positive liberty means in the positive liberties we can find if you remove all types of constraints mainly for the development of human beings, that is called as positive liberty. Now apart from that, meaning of liberty, if you see, liberty is originated from the Latin word liber, which means free from all type of restriction. Children, whenever if you are free from all type of restriction, then we can say that you are in liberty, you are enjoying the liberty, which means free. Free from what? Free from all type of restrictions, all type of limitations, okay, all type of boundaries, etc. So whenever if you are free from all type of restriction, then that is called as liberty. So the word liberty is originated from the Latin word liber, which means to set free from all type of restrictions, okay. This is one point. Next we'll go forward. Third important point, definitions we have to see. Definitions, when you are seeing J.R. Seeley. So J.R. Seeley, what he is saying, liberty is nothing but an absence of restraint. Just now in the introduction point we have seen, liberty is nothing but absence of all type of limitation, all type of holding back, all type of restriction. So liberty is nothing but an absence of restraint. So this was stated by a definition. His name is J.R. Seeley. Okay. So J.R. Seeley. Now we'll go forward. We have now types of liberty. When we are learning, we have different type of liberty, which is called natural liberty, civil liberty, economic liberty, political liberty, and national liberty. So overall we have how many types of liberty? We have 5 types of liberty. So one is called natural liberty, one is called civil liberty, one is called economic liberty, one is called political liberty, and one is called national liberty. So children, in this class we will discuss briefly about a concept about which liberty? Natural liberty. What is meant by natural liberty? We will study in the concept. Natural liberty denotes freedom from all type of restrictions and all type of social customs, okay, religious restrictions, okay. Whenever when you are free from all type of restrictions, then we can say you are a natural liberty. So its meaning, synonyms, it's what is meant by national liberty is injustice and anarchy, disturbances will form. Okay, natural liberty in the sense completely free. So understanding, so even in the society some limitations are very very important. In the societies, in the social conditions, in the social environment, some limitations will be there. Complete free in the sense, if you are giving completely freedom, then what will happen? That is one type of injustice, and sometime it will cause disturbances also, which is called anarchy. Okay. Now these types of liberty, natural liberty, we can't find in the present society, because in the present society most of the people are living in the community, they are living in the society. So in this area, natural liberty you can't find today. At present you can't find these types of natural liberty, but many people believe that these types of liberty were prevalent during the pre-social conditions and pre-state human life. During the ancient time, okay, during the ancient period, when the society was not developed, during that period there was a natural liberty. But at present condition, at present stage, if you see, there is no natural liberty. So in this natural liberty, all the persons are free to do anything else. So complete freedom, okay, when all the persons are free to do anything, that is called as natural liberty. So now it is not possible in the civilized society. Now at present, whatever the societies are there, civilized, highly educated, okay, able to know what is right and what is wrong. Okay, the civilized society is nothing but the society which are highly educated, which are leaning towards the development of science and technology, which can able to distinguish between the what is right and what is wrong. Now the society is a civilized society. In this civilized society, we can't find natural liberty. Okay, it is not possible in the civilized society. According to this concept, no rules and regulations should be there, except laws of nature should be followed. Okay, except the laws of nature which are mainly followed in natural liberty. So no rules and regulations will be there, okay, only the laws of nature, okay, that only will be prevalent, that is a natural liberty. So in natural liberty, complete freedom will be given. These types of liberties are mainly followed in the ancient time, but as soon as when the society started forming, civilized societies forming, these types of liberty was not at present prevalent. Okay, these types of liberty. According to this concept, no rules and regulations should be followed except the laws of nature. Now, natural liberty, they believes that, okay, natural liberty believe that once upon a time it was existed during the pre-social condition and pre-state human conditions. When human life was in the previously, when the human life started, okay, and when the social life was not formed, during that period of time, there was a natural liberty. So what we have understand about this, so children, we have understand about natural liberty, in which we have understand that natural liberty denotes freedom, freedom from all types of restrictions and freedom from all type of social customs. Okay, its meaning, when you are, what is the meaning is, natural liberty is meanings is just injustice and this is anarchy. Why? Because if you see that sometime if you are giving complete freedom, then what will happen, it will cause disturbances also in the society. Even in today also, freedom is there. Man is not completely freedom. In today's society, freedom will be given, but some restrictions will be there, so that the society should be in the good condition. Some rules and regulations should be there, but natural liberty resembles that complete freedom should be given, no rules and regulations should be given, and only the natural law should be followed. The law of nature will be followed. So these types of liberty you can't find in the present society. And in these types of liberty, all the persons are free to do anything else. Now it is not possible for the civilized society. According to this concept, rules and regulations should be there, but except, no rules and regulations should be there, but except there should be laws of nature. So many people believe that these types of society, natural liberty was there during the pre-social conditions and pre-human conditions we can find. So what we have studied in this concept, children, in this concept first we have discussed about introduction point, in which we have seen that liberty is quite a distinctive qualities in the man when we are comparing it with the animals. Liberty have two important sense, one is negative sense as well as positive sense. From the liberty, when we are removing all type of restraints and constraints, then that is called as negative liberty, such as act of stopping or holding back. Okay, when you are removing all type of possible constraints for the development of human being, that is called as positive liberty. Okay, so restraints and constraints meaning is similar, act of stopping something to do, restricting someone to do, or making them someone to be in limit. So this is called as restraints and constraints. Then we have discussed about what is called natural liberty. Natural liberty denotes freedom from all types of restraints and social customs. Its meaning is equivalent to the injustice as well as anarchy, because when we are providing complete natural liberty, then it can cause disturbances in the society. At present society, you can't find these types of liberty. These types of liberty, natural liberty, states that all the person are free to do anything else. But now it is not possible in the civilized society. In civilized society, some rules and regulations will be there. Certain rules and regulations we have to follow. We have to run according to the rules and regulations. In the ancient society, we have natural liberty. But in the present society, in the civilized developed society, we can't find these types of liberty. According to this concept, no rules and regulations should be there, but except the laws of nature they'll follow. And some estimators are believing that natural liberty was existed during the pre-social conditions and pre-state human life. As soon as when human life started, okay, during that period of time, these types of liberty was there, which is called natural liberty. So children, in the next class, we'll discuss about some other concept. We'll discuss with civil liberty, what is economic liberty, in the next class. Okay, thank you very much, everybody.